I thank my colleague, Representative Bobeck, for supporting, and all my colleagues for supporting House Resolution 725, which names Pennsylvania Female Veterans Day as March 28, 2018. This resolution honors female veterans who have been serving our country as far back as the Revolutionary War. Pennsylvania is home to the 8th highest number of women veterans at just about over 60,000. Across the United States, more than 1.8 million women have answered the call to fight for their nation. They are, of course, our sisters, our daughters, our grandmothers, and mothers as well. In the military, like anywhere, we find women making a difference. Their history would be a hard-fought one. Only allowed to serve in an official capacity as recently as 100 years ago, women were still always on the battlegrounds of our nation's most bloody conflicts, including during the Revolutionary War, the War of 1812, the Mexican War, and the Spanish-American War. Many healed wounds and fed male soldiers. Some even disguised themselves to fight on the battlefield. Despite their contributions, it wasn't until World War I that they were allowed to officially enlist in special women's corps. And it wasn't even until just 3 years ago that they were finally awarded the right to sign on for all combat roles offered in all branches of the U.S. military. Talk about a long fight for a group of women who just wanted to fight for our country. But their fight reminds us that we as legislators need to do more to provide for these women. We can and we must do better to provide sufficient health care for our women veterans. In the state legislature right now, we're fighting for a Women's Veterans Healthcare Task Force. The goal of this task force would be to study the health issues facing women veterans and make policy recommendations to the governor and General Assembly. For instance, we know women often present symptoms differently than men for many issues, including PTSD. We need to understand these differences in order to better serve our women veterans here in the Commonwealth. Just as the fight for women's rights is not over, the fight for women's equal treatment in the military has just begun. We have come a long way, but still have a long way to go. We stand in solidarity with our female veterans and sincerely thank them for their courage, their sacrifice, and their dedication. Thank you.